Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Welcome all to the programming screencast of Facebook Sentiment Analysis. I'll be going step by step and explain you how to do Facebook sentiment analysis. We'll be giving you background of sentiment analysis and other things too. So let us start with the programming screencast. So first of all, what do you have to do in here is, first of all, you have to download the Facebook data and store it in Excel file. I'll show you how can you download the Facebook data. For that, you must log in to your Facebook account. So here is my Facebook account. I have already logged in here. First of all, you need to download your Facebook data. How can you do that? For that, you must go to the settings in your profile. As you are saying, I'll go to the settings. Here, I have your Facebook information. As you can see, I have a tab on the left pane, your Facebook information. So click on that. Here is my Facebook information. Here I have download your information. You can download a copy of your information to keep or to transfer to another service. So click on that, view. As you all can see, I have my Facebook account information here. I have the information in the form of posts, photos and videos, comments, likes and reactions, friends, etc., etc. So first of all, you need to create a file here. You can see this button, create file. Click on this. As you can see, here it is written, your file is being processed. We'll let you know when it's complete. So it will take some time to create the file and then you can download your file. Yes. So I have already downloaded my Facebook information. I'll show you. Here I have Facebook and my username. And you can see I have all the information in here. I have about you, I have friends, my followers, messages, pages, payment history, everything is stored here. So when you will create file here and download your file, your information will be downloaded in the form of these folders. Yes, you will be given one zip folder, and in that folder you will be given this information. You will be given the information about your friends, about your groups, likes, reactions, messages, everything will be there. So here is our information. What you need to do next is, you need to store this information in an Excel file. Yes, so I'll just show you. For example, I have folder here named post. So I'll just click here. Here I have my post, other people's post to my timeline and my own post too. So I have opened this page. So here is my post. It is basically your post. That means only my posts are shown here. These are all the posts that I have posted on my timeline. So what you need to do here is, you need to store this post in an Excel file. For that, I have created an Excel file. For example, here, all the posts I have stored in an Excel file. So you need to do the same thing. You need to just copy your post from this HTML file and you need to paste these posts in an Excel file. Okay. I'll repeat, how can you download your Facebook data? First of all, you need to go to the settings in your Facebook profile. In settings, you will be given Facebook information. You need to click on the Facebook information tab on the left pane. After going there, you'll be asked to download your information here. First of all, you need to create file. The file or the folder will be created and you'll be given a folder like this. You'll be given a folder like this. Here you'll be having each and every information related to your Facebook profile, information regarding your friends, your post, network information. So this is how you can download your Facebook data. For our program, you need to save this information in an Excel file. So you pick any folder. For example, I picked post and then I opened your post.html, which came like this. And I stored these posts in an Excel file. I just copied these posts and stored it in an Excel file. As you can see, these are all the posts that I have stored here. Okay, so you just save this post in an Excel file and save this file. We'll be using this file for our program. This is how you can download your Facebook information and store it in Excel file. So first and the foremost step is you need to download your Facebook data and store it in an Excel file. Then what you need to do is you need to import the pandas library. What purpose does it serve? It provides easy to use data structure for data analysis. We will get to know what are these data structures eventually in our programming screencast. Then you need to import the NLTK library. It is a library which is used to process human language. Yes, it is a library which is used to process human language. What does NLTK do here? It provides sentiment analysis of human data. So what is sentiment analysis? Sentiment analysis involves working out whether a piece of text is positive, negative, or neutral. For example, if I ask you, how are you? This is a neutral sentence. And if I say, I'm very, very happy today, this is a positive sentence. And if I say, I don't know where my life is going and I'm very sad, so this is a negative sentence. So sentiment analysis involves working out a piece of text and figuring out whether it is positive, negative, or neutral. So this is sentiment analysis. So what we'll be doing here is the file that you have stored, the post that you have stored in an Excel file, we'll be analyzing them on the basis of sentiment analysis. We'll be analyzing your post, that whether your posts are negative, positive, or neutral. So this is Facebook sentiment analysis. Then we will use Vader. What is Vader? Vader is Valence Aware Dictionary and Sentiment Reasoner. Yes, Vader, it is used for sentiment analysis, but it not only tells you whether a piece of text is positive, negative, or neutral, it also takes into account the intensity of the sentiment. Yes, it also takes into account the intensity of the sentiment. What do I mean by that? For example, I said I'm very, very happy today. That it will also tell me that this sentence is 80% positive or 70% positive. It will also tell me the intensity of my sentiment. Okay, so we'll be using Vader here. Vader stands for Valence Aware Dictionary and Sentiment Reasoner. It takes into account the intensity of the sentiment. So you need to download the Vader lexicon. What is the lexicon? Lexicon acts as a dictionary here. Then you need to convert your Excel sheet that you have created to data frame with the help of pandas. What is a data frame? A data frame is a two-dimensional structure in the form of a table. So pandas provides you with the data frame facility. As I said, pandas provides you easy to use data structure, and data frame is one of them. We'll be using them in our program. So this is a step-by-step guide to our program. How can we do Facebook sentiment analysis? I know some of the things are not clear here. When we'll do programming screencast, everything will become clear here. So I'll just revise what we have done till now. First of all, you need to download your Facebook data. You need to log in to your Facebook account, and then you need to go to settings and download your Facebook information there. You need to store your information in an Excel file that I have already explained. Then you need to import the pandas library. It basically provides you easy to use data structure for data analysis. Then you need to import NLTK library. NLTK library will help you to process the human language. It will basically help you to analyze the human data. It will help you in sentimental analysis of human data. Sentiment analysis involves working out whether a piece of text is positive, negative, or neutral. I've already given you example of a positive, neutral, and negative sentences. Then we'll not be using only NLTK, we'll be using Vader too, because Vader also takes into account the intensity of the sentiment. Yes. And then you need to download the Vader lexicon. Lexicon acts as a dictionary here. You also need to convert your Excel sheet that you have created to a data frame. What is a data frame? Data frame is basically a two-dimensional structure in the form of table, which is provided by Pandas library. So this is it. Now we'll be proceeding to the programming screencast in the next video. Thank you. So now let us start with the programming screencast of Facebook sentiment analysis. I hope you have watched the previous videos. If you haven't, I suggest you to watch the previous videos and then start with the program of Facebook sentiment analysis. I think you all know what is sentiment analysis now. So what is basically sentiment analysis? Sentiment analysis helps you to figure out whether a piece of text is positive, negative, or neutral. Yes, Facebook sentiment analysis will help you realize the sentiment analysis of your Facebook data. So first of all, you need to download your Facebook data. The steps have already been explained in the previous video. So you first download your Facebook data and store it in an Excel file. You download your Facebook data and store it in an Excel file. We'll be using this Excel file in our program. So as already explained, you first need to import the pandas library. So I'll just write import pandas as pd. Then you also need to import the NLTK library, which will help you in sentiment analysis. I'll write import NLTK. After that, you need to import the Vader library. So what do you need to do here is, you write from NLTK dot sentiment dot Vader import sentiment intensity analyzer. So you need to import these three libraries, pandas, NLTK, and from Vader you need to import sentiment intensity analyzer. Then I asked you to download the Vader lexicon. You can download directly from here. I'll just write the command. Please pay attention. I'll write NLTK dot downloader dot download and in bracket you need to write Vader underscore lexicon. Lexicon basically acts as a dictionary here, so you need to also download that. For downloading the lexicon, you have a command nltk.downloader.download and in bracket you need to write Vader underscore lexicon. Then I'll load my file here. What my file name is data underscore file dot xlsx. This is my file name. In the previous videos, like in speech recognition, you had a doubt that where do we need to store the file? which we are going to use in the program. For example, in speech recognition, we used audio file. All of you had a doubt that how, where do we need to store that file? Actually, you can store that file anywhere in your system. The bottom line is you need to provide proper path to your file. Yes, you need to provide proper path to your file. For example, here my data underscore file is in downloads. So I'll give a proper path here. The path here is basically users Simran Setia. That is my username. Then in that I have the downloads folder. And in that I have my data file, okay? So I hope that is clear to all of you. You need to provide a proper path, okay? You can store your file anywhere, but you need to provide proper path in your program. So I have loaded my file, that is done. It is basically XLSX. So I've imported the libraries. I've also downloaded the Vader underscore lexicon, and then I've also loaded my data file here. So next, what you need to do is you need to read from the Excel file. So I'll just write Excel is equal to PD. I'll use pandas library to read my Excel file. I'll write Excel file and in bracket, where is my Excel file? It has been loaded in the variable file. So what this is doing, this is reading from the read from Excel. I repeat, pandas library will help you to, it is basically pd dot, pandas library will help you to read from the Excel file. So you will write pd, because I have imported pandas as pd. I'll write pd dot Excel file and in bracket I'll write my file variable name, and that is file here. Okay, so I have read my Excel file with the help of pandas library. As I already said, pandas provide you with easy to use data structures. So we'll be parsing this Excel file and converting this Excel file to data frame. What is a data frame? As explained, data frame is a two-dimensional structure in the form of a table. So data frames will help you to analyze your data easily. As you all know, pandas library provide you with this facility. You can convert your Excel file to some other data structure which are easy to analyze. Yes, so we'll be converting our Excel file to data frame. So I'll just write DFS is equal to Excel dot parse, and I'll write Excel dot sheet underscore names 0. Here we are storing our information in the first column, so I'll write 0 here. I'll just show you. For example, in the first column only, I have stored all my post information. You can see here, I have stored all the information in the first column, so I'll write 0 here. So I'll write hash. What is this statement doing? Parsing the Excel sheet to data frame. Parsing the Excel sheet to data frame. Next, what you have to do here is you need to update your data frames as per your requirement. For example, here I have some blank rows here. As you can see, I have some blank rows here. I need to delete these blank rows from my data frames. So I'll just write DFS is equal to list DFS, and in square brackets I'll write timeline, because that is the name of my column. Okay, and then I'll also print all the DFS. So what it is basically doing here is it is removing the row from the data frame. I'll write it removes the blank rows from the data frame. So we will just run our program here and see how data frames are coming. So I'll just run. I first need to store my file. I'll store facebook.py. So as you can see, I have my data in the form of data frames. Whatever has been written in the Excel file is here, because I have converted that Excel file to data frames. So we have the data frames here. Now we have the data frames. So next step would be analyzing them. So we'll do sentiment analysis on these data frames. So what will I write here? First of all, I'll initialize my sentiment intensity analyzer. I'll write SID is equal to sentiment intensity analyzer. Then, as you can see in my Excel file, I have this information too, that when my post was posted, for example, the particular time and the date has already been is also been written. So I need not analyze this information, the particular time information. So what will I do here is, whenever this sentiment analyzer would encounter this, the timeline information, the time information, it won't analyze it. It will only analyze my post. Okay, I repeat here. For example, I have here Monday, March 27, 2017. So this has nothing to do with sentiment analysis. So I'll just remove this. I'll not remove here from the Excel file. I'll hard code it in my program so that whenever my program encounters this particular statement, this time information, it skips that information and it doesn't do sentiment analysis on that information. So I'll just write here, I'll store it in str1. So what is the information? It is basically UTC plus 0530. So it may be different for your Excel files. So you need to check in your Excel files. If there is such kind of information, you can skip that information because this has nothing to do with the sentiment analysis. So now I'll write for data in DFS, A is equal to data.findstr1. This particular command will find str1 in my Excel file, in my data frames, and if it will basically return a boolean value here. For example, if it returns -1 here, that means it hasn't found that str1 in that particular A. For example, here I have the data, and if it encounters this particular line, Monday, March 27, 2017, and it has encountered this str1 also here. So it won't return -1 here because it has found that UTC plus 530 here. But if it hasn't found that UTC plus 530 here, that means it is an information that needs to be analyzed. That we need to analyze this particular information. We need to perform sentiment analysis on this particular information. So if it hasn't found this str1, that means we need to analyze that particular statement. So I'll just write SS is equal to SID dot polarity underscore scores data. Whatever data it has encountered, now it needs to be analyzed. We need to perform sentiment analysis on it. So it will print the data here also, and then for K in SS, write print K and then SS of K. It will basically print whether a given information is positive, negative or neutral, and it will also print the intensity of the sentiment too. I'll just run this file, then you'll get to know what I'm trying to say here. So I'll just run it. Let us run this. So super, we have all the information here. We have all the timeline information here. So for example, my first post was this, Rohit Sharma wants to read the murder of Roger, whatever it is. And then it has given the polarity also, that it is 0.251 negative, it is 0.749 neutral, and it is 0 positive. And it is also given some compound information. Compound information is aggregate of all the sentiments. For example, it is negative also and it is neutral also, but the compound information says that it is minus 0.69. That means it is negative. So similarly, in the forthcoming post 2, it has written that it is 0 negative, it is 0.721 neutral, and it is 0.279 positive. And it is also given the compound information. Since the negative value here is 0 and it is positive, so the compound information, the compound sentiment is also positive here. So it has analyzed each and every information given in the Excel file, and it has written that whether it is negative, neutral, positive, and also the compound sentiment that we can figure out from this information. So I think now everything is clear to you guys. I'll revise the each step here also. So first of all, what you need to do here is you need to import the libraries. Basically, you need to import 3 libraries here. You need to import Pandas, you need to import NLTK, and you also need to import Vader here. So I have imported these 3 libraries. I have downloaded the Vader underscore lexicon. You also need to download that. And then I need to load the file here. Since I have already explained, you need to provide proper path to your file. You can store your file anywhere in your system. Then I read from the Excel file. After reading from the Excel file, I parse the Excel file to data frames. Yes, data frames is the facility that has been provided to us by the Pandas library. Data frames are basically a two-dimensional structure in the form of a table. It makes the analysis easy. And then I have removed the blank rows that are present in my Excel file. So this is how you do it. After that, I have printed my data frames, that each and every data frame is printed here. After that, I have initialized my sentiment intensity analyzer. And then I have explained you guys that in my Excel file, I have also the time information, the time at which my post was posted on my timeline. So I need not analyze this information. This has no relevance. So whenever my program encounters this particular STR, that is the time information, and then it skips that particular statement and goes to the next statement. So for that, I have taken a variable A here. Whenever in my data STR1 is found, and if STR1 is found, it needs to skip that. For example, that means if its value is minus 1, it hasn't found that STR1. Yes, I repeat, if its value is minus 1, it hasn't found that STR1. So now I need to analyze that particular statement. So if A value is minus 1, that means it hasn't found that particular statement, that particular time information. So I'll just analyze that statement. For that, I need to write sid.polarity_scores, and in bracket, you need to supply data. Then I have printed that data. And then for K in SS, I have printed the particular K. K will denote here whether it is negative, neutral, or positive, and SSK will tell you the intensity of that particular sentiment. So K here is the sentiment, SS of K here is the intensity of the sentiment. I hope that this programming screencast was useful to you guys and you have understood it well. And if you have any doubts, please post on the discussion forum. We are there to help you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Guess what? Today is my birthday, and I got this pack of letters written anonymously by my friends. Well, now I have to figure out who has written which letter. Can we write a code for this? Well, let us find out in our next Joy, Natural Language Processing.
Observe the conversation happening between these two teachers. One teacher is getting her feedback by the students, and the other teacher is just listening to whatever this teacher is saying. Let us see the conversation now.
and Amika.
Hey, how are you?
So, how has the semester been?
Semester has been great, and that's also reflected in the feedback form that I received from the students which are graduating.
Oh, nice.
And there's one particular form that I would like to show you for two reasons.
Okay.
Firstly, there are a lot of nice things written in it about me. And second thing is that I have a feeling who would have written this.
Wait a second, they're anonymous feedback, right?
Yeah,
so
yeah,
how do you know who has written it?
Yeah, yeah, they are anonymous, but from the style with which they write, and given that I have checked their exam sheets right from the beginning, I have a feeling of the style that they use. So this sheet, you see, there are a lot of the usage and a lot of adjectives. So I have a feeling who would have written this.
Oh, wow.
See what just happened? One teacher by name Anamika is talking to another teacher, Varsha, about her feedback. As a teacher, students have given her some feedback. And in that feedback particularly, Anamika is impressed with one such student's feedback, who has given her a whole lot of compliments. And most importantly, Anamika realizes that although the feedback is anonymous, she has a feeling who might have written this feedback. How? She understands some sort of the way it is written, the sentence, the grammar, and the style of writing in general. Given that she's a teacher of a classroom, she probably knows how her students write. She is trying to figure out who this student could be who has given her compliments. Is it really true that we can look at the style of writing and then conclude that this is the person who has written this letter? Let us do a small experiment. We have this huge repository called the Project Gutenberg. All you can do there is download a whole lot of books that are available in text format, free of cost. Without any, none of these things are copyrighted material. You can get this material and then analyze the data with your programming skills. Now, I would like to take a look at some authors' complete work and try to figure out if we can see some signatures in their writing.
Hello guys, welcome to the Stylometry with Python. What exactly stylometry is? Stylometry is the quantitative study of literacy style. It is based on the observation that authors tend to write in relatively consistent, recognizable, and unique ways. For example, some people write in short sentences while others prefer long blocks of text consisting of many clauses. Everyone has their own unique vocabulary, sometimes rich, sometimes limited. No two people use semicolons, dashes, and other forms of punctuation in the exact same way. Scholars have used stylometry as a tool to study a variety of questions. For example, a considerable amount of research has studied the differences between the ways in which men and women write. Isn't it cool? So in this tutorial, we'll see a stylometric analysis to a set of English language texts using analytical library of Python. Let's see this. What's the idea? Scholar T.C. Mendenhall in his paper said that an author's stylistic signature could be found by counting how often he or she used words of different lengths. For example, if you pick a novel and count word lengths in a 5000 word segment and then plot a graph of the word length distribution, the curve would look pretty much the same no matter what part of the novel we had built. So isn't it cool? We'll use this idea, we'll count the number of words of different lengths and then plot it. With this plot, we'll try to understand the author's style of writing. This analysis is a very basic one. There are many advanced ways of doing such classifications. But since it is a very basic course, we'll just motivate you with the idea. So let's see this. Hello guys, so in this video we'll prepare the data set. So as the instructor said, we'll go to the Project Gutenberg. You can see the link here. If you go to this web page, you'll see there are many ebooks which you can download for free as a text version. So we are going to use these ebooks for our analysis. So for you, what we have done, we have created an archive which contains all the which contains selected papers which we are going to use for our analysis. So you need to download and unzip the archive of some papers containing 85 documents that we will use for our analysis. These 85 documents have been extracted from this Project Gutenberg ebook version. When you unzip the archive, it will create a directory called data. So you will have a folder named data. This will be our working directory. So what you have to do, you have to, whatever Python code you are going to create, just create it in this data folder. We have the data, we'll be using NLTK library, which comes with the Anaconda Cloud. So you can just try importing NLTK in your Python console and you can see that it is working. Make sure you download all the collections of NLTK using NLTK download. So before we can proceed with the analysis, we need to load the files containing all the 85 papers into convenient data structures. Okay. The first step is to assign each of the 85 papers to the proper set. Since all the files have a standard format, we can easily assign each paper to its corresponding authors. For this, we'll use the dictionary data structure. So the idea with the dictionary data structure is it comes with the key and the value pair. So with each key, you can store its value and you can easily access this particular value using the key. So if some of you know basic data structure, then you must know hashing also. In hashing, what we do, we create a hash of a particular data, and whenever that we want to extract the data, we'll use that hash value to extract the data. So the dictionary data type contains key value pairs. In our case, the key would be the author's name and the list of paper numbers will be the values associated with these keys. So let's see the data one. So I am on this web page. You can click on the link given in the description to download the data. So if you click, you will get to this page. You can just click on the download button to download the data. I've already downloaded it. You will get an archive version of the data. Just click on it so to unzip it, and you will get a folder named data. So I have this folder named data. I'll just open it and I can see all the texts. So name of the files are federalist_1234 and so on. These are the files which have been written by some of the authors, and our key idea is to understand their style of writing so that we can get some idea how we can distinguish different authors using their style of writing. So our analysis will use these files as input and will plot the word length distribution, and through that we'll try to make some sense that whether different people write in a different way or not. So these are key idea and these are input file. Please download it, please see it once, and let's start with the code. So we are splitting the papers into 5 categories. So these categories are these files, for example, are we are going to split categorize these files into 5 categories. First, there are 51 papers known to have been written by Alexander Hamilton, and there are in these files there are 14 papers to have been written by James Madison. 4 of the 5 papers are known to have been written by John Jay, and 3 papers were co-written by Madison and Hamilton. And there are 12 papers disputed between Hamilton and Madison, which we don't know who exactly was the author of these 12 papers. So our idea is to understand the style of writing of these papers and then try to analyze these 12 papers whether they were written by Hamilton or Madison. So we will use our key idea which we discussed in previous videos, that we'll try to plot the word length distribution, and with this we'll try to see whether is it really that people have different way of writing, people have different way of writing papers such that they use different length of words differently. So in next video we'll try to write a code for this, and we'll plot the graph of this word length distribution, and we'll try to analyze the data. Thank you. So I'll start with the code, by preparing the data. So first I'll prepare a dictionary name paper. Let me first import the NLTK. So NLTK is working or not, let me check first. So I'll write in the IPython console import NLTK. So you can see that it's not throwing any error. It means it has been imported successfully. Before you start your coding, you need to download all the constraint or all the collections of NLTK. So for that, I will write NLTK dot download. This function will open a new API through which you can download all the collections of NLTK. This is required for this stylometric analysis. So I'll just download everything. So up to it downloads, we'll start with our dictionary thing. So I'll write papers as the dictionary. So the first author is name is Madison. So Madison. And the key is Madison, and the values will be the list of papers which he wrote. So so the lists are 10, 14, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, and 48. So these are the file names. If you see the files, the name is, the first name is same for all the files Federalist, but after underscore there is a numbering. So I'm defining these numbers as a list here. Okay, so for Madison, he wrote these as I told in the last video that Madison wrote around 14 papers. So these are the 14 papers which he wrote. And then we'll create the dictionary for Hamilton. So I'll put a comma and then I'll write Hamilton. And Hamilton wrote around 52 papers. So I'll write those 52 numbers which are present there. 1, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I've written the list for Hamilton. After that, after Hamilton comes the J. So I'll create the key and value pair for J. So J, and the values will be J wrote 4 papers. So 2, 3, 4, and 5. And after J, we have shared papers of Madison and Hamilton. So I'll just write shared, and the values and the list of values are, value list are 18, 19, and 20. So three papers they wrote collaboratively, and there are disputed papers which we are not sure of who exactly wrote this paper. So I will just write disputed, and the value will be a list of some papers which are 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 62, and 63. So these are the papers which are disputed, and we really don't know who exactly wrote. So we are going to analyze for these papers exactly. We'll see that who can write these paper by analyzing the word length graph of all the authors which we have stated before the disputed papers. Okay, so our data is the dictionary is created. Now I'll create a definition of reading files. So what the idea is, let me write the definition name, read files. Okay, this will take take one argument, name is file name. And what we are going to do, we'll create another dictionary, and this dictionary, what it will contain, it will contain the key value as the author's name, and the key will be the author's name, and the value will be whatever he wrote. Will keep all the data in a particular list as a string. So the key will be the author's name, and the value will be all the data, whatever he lost, whatever he wrote. So all the data as a single string. So let me create a list of list name string. So strings as list. Okay. And I'll create my loop as for file and file name. The file name is my argument. With open, I'll open my file as, so my file name is federalist, and with an underscore, and now we'll add the curly braces so that I can put the file name. So what exactly is this? It is the key value which I the corresponding value for each key which for each author. So I'll put it here and dot txt. So I'll created the string for the file name so that I can open the exact file of particular author. I'll open it as f, and I'll append strings, which the strings the list which I created, the name of the list is strings dot append. And what I am going to append, the file which I just opened as f, I'll read this f dot read, and whatever it is reading, I'll just append it into this string list. Okay, and I'll just join it and return it. So what I am going to return is slash n dot join the string. That's it. So what I'm going to do with this function, each time for each author, I'll send the file name is the list of the which contains the numbers, and through that these numbers I'll read the file which is present in the data folder for the corresponding author, and I'll get all the data for a particular author, read the string and put it in a single list. Okay, what I'm going to do with the single list, we'll see in the next video. Thank you. So you can see here, I have downloaded all the collections for NLTK. You can see it's written whatever I needed to download. Everything has been installed here, and we'll go to our program. Let me just zoom it. We can see. Everything is visible. Now I've defined what my function is exactly, and what this paper's dictionary is doing. I'll just save it, just run it again, so everything looks perfect. By running it, I have created the paper's dictionary. So if I just type in my, let me just zoom this one, in my IPython console here, you can see the IPython console. If I type PA papers, you can see the dictionary. Medicine contains a list of all his papers. Hamilton contains list of all his 52 papers. J contains 4 papers. Shared are 3, and these are 12 disputed papers. So our dictionary is okay. Let me clear it. Okay. So next, what you have to do? We have to call this function so that we create the actual dictionary that we wanted to create. Our main dictionary is the dictionary. The key value will be the author's name, and the list. Key will be the author's name, and the value will be the string of words. All the sentence, all the words in a single string, so that we can analyze it easily. So for that, what we are going to do, we will create a dictionary out of the author's corpora. So let me write here. Give the name of the dictionary as Federalist by author. Okay, so this is a dictionary, and let me write the loop for author comma files in papers dot items. Okay, so Let me just try this once, what exactly it does. So let's see my IPython console. I'll just try this loop for I, comma, J, in. I already created this papers dictionary. So papers dot items. Okay, and I'll just print I and J. Okay, you can see it's printing all the values, medicine and what and his list, Hamilton and his list, and J and his list, shared all the list, the list disputed and the list. So it's working perfectly. I wanted this only. So I'll go to the next line. What I'm going to do, so authors will give me, so what I is, I will give me the name of the author, and J is giving me the list. So author here, the variable author will give me the name of the author, and files here will give me the list. So files contains list, author contains the author's name. So what I'm going to do, this dictionary, which the empty dictionary which I just created, I'll use this. So literal list by author, and the key is what? Key is the author's name. So here it is author, key is author. So I create a key of this author which I'm looking through, and what will be the value is the list. So what I will do, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to call this function now, read files, and I'm going to call this function by giving the list as a parameter. This file name will be my list. So files, so what it will do, the list will go here. Okay, then all the numbers in this list contain numbers. So for all the numbers, it will read all the files for that particular author, and then concatenate all the words, strings, whatever it is, into a single list. Okay, and that list I have for a particular author, I'll use it to analyze. What my idea is, I'll use that list, I'll count all the words of a particular length, and I'll plot the distribution. That's it. Okay, so now you know what I'm exactly doing, why I'm calling this function here. So this will give me the list of all the words for a particular author. So my dictionary will contain everything here. Okay, I'm getting some errors. So what's the problem is, I put here file name rather than file. Okay, so let's run this. Cool, it's working. So I'll just try to print this so that everything looks perfect. So for author and papers, print this my federal list by author, the author. Author is my variable here, and I'll just print something, some sliced 100 characters, so that let's see everything is working or not. So I'm getting something, it means the dictionary is perfect. I'll just delete this. Okay, so my dictionary has been created. Now the only thing I have to do is, on this dictionary, I have the data, I've done the pre-processing. I'll do the analysis. I'll count the word and their length, and I'll plot the distribution, and I'll see it whether is there any difference or not. Let's see this in next video. Thank you. So everything is ready. We have created the dictionary federalist by authors, which contains all the data, where key is the author's name, and the value is the author's data. Now what we have to do, we have to create a words distribution, word length distribution exactly. So we'll count the word with a particular length, we'll count them, and we'll create a graph out of it. So let me create a tuple named author, authors, and the first one is Hamilton, second is Madison, third is disputed, then we have J, and the shared documents. Okay, my tuple is there for authors. I'll create two dictionaries, author tokens, Okay, let me explain these dictionaries. Let me create first. N length distribution. So what I'm going to do, I'll go through all these authors, and whatever dictionary I created in this dictionary, the key value is the author's name. You can see all these author's name are exactly the key values here. I'll take the string, the data contains everything, and I'll remove all the punctuated things, other letters. Only the words will be there. I'll take only the words, because what we want is the word and their length. So what I will do, I'll create a loop for author in authors is my authors list. Yeah, me tokens is equal to, I'll create a token is equal to nltk dot, there is a like a method for it, word tokenize. So what it does, or it takes a string and create tokens out of it. I mean, each word will be each string, each token tokenize. So everything, for example, punctuated letters, words, everything will be tokenized. Tokenize what? I'll take the data. So data is present in this dictionary, Federalist by author, and I'm taking for each author. This, oh, I didn't import NLTK. Import NLTK. Okay. So this is done. After that we'll filter out the punctuations. For that there is an NLTK library for it. So I'll take the author tokens as okay. So the dictionary I created. Okay, and the key value will be the author. And now here's the tricky part. I have to remove all the punctuations here, so I'll do it in a very small code. So let's see this first. For token in tokens, you know what tokens is here. Okay, if any, now here it is c dot alpha. This is a function for c in token. So what I'm doing for each token in tokens, I'm checking whether it is an alphabet, is it made of all the characters only, or not any other special characters or numbers, something. If it is only alphabets, then I'll create a list of it, otherwise I'll discard it. So for token in tokens, put the token there. So put that token in this list. That's it. So this line is nothing else. You can do it in another way also. I just wanted to put it in a single line. So for token in tokens, if it's an alpha character with, for c in token, whatever token I am getting here is a string. So for c in token means all the words in this string. If it is made up of only alphabets, I'll put this token inside the list. Otherwise I'll discard it. So this is done. I got the words out of the for each author. Now I just have to calculate the length of it. So token length, which I created, token length, okay, token length will be, again let me just write it again, for token in author tokens. Of what authors? For token in author tokens, for token, put what length of it? The token. So I got the loop. I'm iterating over all the words which I got for each author, and I'm just getting the list of lengths. That's it. Great. I got the list. After that, I want to get the length distribution of author. So I'll create a list out of it. Length. Distributions authors, okay, and I'll call nltk dot freq frequency distribution. This is the function name. Now I'll pass the token length and I'll just plot. Length distributions, okay, of author, and let's just plot it. So maximum length I'll put as 15, up to 15 words, length of 15 words, sorry. Title is equal to author. Author means what? Whenever it will plot, it will show for which author this plot is. Sorry, this dictionary is length distribution, not distributions. Yeah, that's why it was throwing the warning error. So now it's fine. Let me just make it a little bit big. I just run it. Okay, I'm getting some error. Str object has no attribute alpha. Oh, sorry, I just is alpha, because I'm checking whether it is an alphabet or not. Okay, let me run it again. Okay, you can see the plots here. You can see there are plots for Hamilton, Madison, Disputed, and J, and Shared. So there are exactly 5 plots. There are 3 authors: Hamilton, Madison, and J. The shared plot is for the documents which were shared by Madison and Hamilton, and disputed are those which we don't know. Now see this, see the plot. It looks exactly almost same, but it's not exactly. If you see the plot of J, the samples are the word count. I mean there are two words, two length words. There are 1200 words, around 1200 words of length 2. And so on. It goes, distribution goes like this for J. It's definitely not what this disputed plot is. It means that whatever the documents are there in the disputed are definitely not written by J. You can see there the beginning and the tail is definitely different for J and the disputed. But if we see, and also if you see the shared one, it looks similar to Hamilton more as compared to the Madison one. But if you see the disputed one, you cannot say who exactly wrote the disputed ones, either it is Madison or Hamilton, but you can definitely say that J didn't write. You can see the plots are different. The beginning part is a little bit similar to the Hamilton one. You can see the beginning of this plot of disputed, but the tail is more or less similar to Madison or even Hamilton, so we cannot even generalize with this. But this is a very fun way of seeing what exactly is going on, or is it anyway related. With this, at least we were able to say that this J definitely didn't write these disputed. This analysis was given, when it was given, it didn't account for the author's way of writing things, how they choose words, what kind of words they choose. There are so many research on this, and it's still a hot area, so people are still working on the stylometry, and now there are so many tools through which you can analyze the author's signature, and you can predict or you can categorize authors' documents by analyzing their styles. So it has so this what the program we did with was just to motivate you with this idea of stylometry. You can exactly actually, given a document, you can do some analysis and get the author's name if you have previous data of it. So this is exactly known as data analysis nowadays, where you have a lot of data and you analyze the data, and you, whenever you get a new data, you try to infer from the past data whether this new data is means something or not. So this was a very very naive example of doing it, because this was the quickest and simple way of doing it. If you go little further, it will become very complex. So since this is a very basic course, we didn't want you to go through the complex ones. So we did this basic analysis to understand the data at least. And we can see the plots, and we can at least infer something through this. There are so many other methods of doing stylometry. You can go to the web and you can just type stylometry and you will get a lot of way. Please see this NLTK library. This is a very good library for analyzing text documents. Actually, it is known as NLPK, NLP analysis. So please see this library. If you have any problem, please post it on discussion forum. Thank you.